Hello, everyone. This video is to let you know that I've published 10 episodes on the basics of fire and smoke simulation in Blender 4.5. The series mainly focuses on understanding the parameters that allow you to modify how fire and smoke are generated, transformed, and rendered. Before I go into detail about the topics of the 10 episodes, let me tell you that the PDF version of all episodes is available for free download at the link you'll find in the description. In the description, you'll also find links to the different episodes of the series. Here's what's covered. In the first episode, we'll talk about the essential elements needed to create a fire and smoke simulation, namely the flow and domain objects, while also introducing the concepts of voxels and resolution. In the second episode, we'll introduce the basics of rendering in cycles, talking about the principal volume material and the emission and blackbody modes it provides. In the third episode, we'll examine the cache, that is, the storage of simulation data on disk. We'll see the available baking modes and how to reuse the saved data. In the fourth episode, we'll go into detail about the parameters of the three types of flow objects, namely geometry, inflow, and outflow. In the fifth episode, we'll start examining the parameters of the domain object in detail, focusing on the settings, gas, fire, and collection sections. In the sixth episode, we'll complete the overview of the domain object parameters, covering the field weights, volumetric data, viewport display, and render sections. In the seventh episode, we'll return to the appearance of fire and smoke in rendering, using the information learned in the previous tutorials to better understand attributes, and how to use them with the emission inputs of the principal volume node. In the eighth episode, we'll see what the two types of effector objects are, namely collider and guide, which allow us to deflect fire and smoke. In the ninth episode, we'll see how force fields let us influence the direction and behavior of fire and smoke, either by disturbing them in a chaotic way or by making them follow defined paths. In the tenth and final episode, we'll cover some rendering-related elements, specifically motion blur, color management, and nodes compositing. We'll also look at the main tools you need to know to render these simulations with EV. As mentioned at the beginning, all videos and the PDF version of the series are already available, and you can find the links in the description. If you enjoy my content, the best way to thank me is to subscribe to the channel and leave a like on the video. Thanks, and see you soon.